Back again on YouTube. Today I wanna share my thoughts on what I think about Kendrick's strategy and Kendrick's tactics towards this beef. So, yeah, to those who know the legendary beef towards Kendrick and Drake. So I'm gonna share my thoughts on that. I'm a South African YouTuber. Yes, you can comment your thoughts on the comment section, what you think about what I'm gonna be speaking about, or just share your thoughts on what you think about Kendrick's strategy towards this beef. So, a lot of people are saying Drake baited Kendrick into this beef. Other people are saying Kendrick is the one who baited Drake into this beef when he declined an offer of being part of the first person shooter track, whereby it's Drake, J. Cole. So, a lot of people are saying allegedly first person shooter was supposed to be Drake, Kendrick, and J. Cole in one track, the big three, the so-called big three. So Kendrick declined the offer, so that's why Drake also took shots in the track, also exposing how there's no big three. He feels like it's just him and J. Cole, it's just the big two. And then J. Cole also exposed how he feels like in this big three, he's the Muhammad Ali of the big three. So he's the top, he's the god, he's the legendary, he's the legend of this big three. Yeah, time went and then Kendrick was featured on a track called Like That. On Like That, Kendrick expressed how he feels about the first person shooter, whereby he exposed that there's no big three, it's just big me, saying that he's the only one who is the rap legend. There's no big three, it's just him. It's big one. It's big him. So J. Cole took Drake and J. Cole took the bait, whereby Drake responded with a track called Push Ups, a fire track, fire bars, fire rapping. Drake was so confident, dissing Kendrick, Kendrick's family, dissing Kendrick's personality, dissing Kendrick's friends, and dissing other rappers in the industry. You know, Push Ups was not just focused on Kendrick, it was focused on a lot of people Drake doesn't like. J. Cole also released a track whereby he was responding, he was dissing Kendrick. Later on, he took the track down and apologized on an event, on a stage, he apologized for dissing Kendrick. He shared his thoughts why he apologized. Yeah, it's fine, I'll speak about that on another video. So, Push Ups came out, that was a great strategy, and Kendrick was not replying, so Drake released another track, you know. I don't know if this was a bait from Kendrick for trying to see what angle will Drake take, or it was a bait from Drake trying to force Kendrick to reply. So he released Taylor Made Freestyle, whereby he impersonated Tupac, he impersonated Snoop Dogg. I'll share my thoughts on what I feel and what I think about that being a mistake that Drake has done in this beef. So yeah, Taylor Made Freestyle came out going fire at Kendrick, using Tupac to force Kendrick to reply, using Snoop Dogg to force Kendrick to reply as AI. So Drake used AI in this beef. I'll speak also about that on another video. So yeah, Kendrick didn't reply for 2 weeks. So there was these two beef tracks, Push Ups and Taylor Made, from Drake dissing Kendrick. Yeah, time is going, 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 2 weeks. People are speaking about how Drake won, how Drake killed Kendrick, how Kendrick is not the GOAT, Drake is the GOAT. Why is Kendrick not replying? So people were forcing Kendrick to reply. That's why they say never poke a snake when he's sleeping in a hole. I don't know if that's the proper way of saying it. But never shogoloza a snake when it's inside a hole. Because when it comes out, hey, Kendrick came. Bah! Euphoria. Shia Drake with a KO. Yes, debatable Drake, Euphoria didn't kill Drake as much. Yeah, Kendrick was exposing a lot of things about Drake. Yeah, you can go and listen to the track and get a proper understanding. I'll release other videos trying to dissect these tracks properly. Yes, I'm on it. So, he released Euphoria. I think that was a proper strategy from Kendrick for releasing Euphoria. You know, because Euphoria, there's a lot of meanings around Euphoria, you know? Yeah, whereby you can speak about Euphoria, speaking about Drake, being in that state of mind, of being in a Euphoria state of mind. Also, speaking about the show Drake was part of, the Euphoria show that is on Netflix, the popular show, Drake was part of it. I don't know if that was another angle Kendrick was taking in this beef, you know? So, that was a proper strategy, releasing Euphoria and naming it Euphoria. So before Drake could reply, bam! Kendrick released 616 in LA, whereby he was exposing he has a mole in Drake's camp, whereby he was exposing that track. It was only released on Kendrick's Instagram, you know, so whereby it is a club like this, the track on Instagram, 616 in LA. There's a lot of meanings around it, whether you talk about Kendrick's birthday, whether you talk about in Toronto. Is it Toronto or in Atlanta? No, not Atlanta, man. In Drake's hood. What is Drake? Canada. 616 is Father's Day. Whether you talk about other things, there's a lot of conspiracies around 616 in LA, you know. So, yeah. I'll get deep into that in other videos. So, 616 in LA was released on Instagram. People went nuts. People went crazy. Commented, shared their thoughts on what they think on it. Then, boom! Family Matters was released. Drake released Family Matters, whereby I was talking about Kendrick's family, was dissing Kendrick's family, was dissing Kendrick's wife, Kendrick's manager, exposing that Kendrick's manager had sex with Kendrick. That beat was crazy. Drake was very confident, was overly confident. He was going in on Kendrick, you know? So, Family Matters was released. Drake went in. Before people could even react and comment, 30 minutes later, Kendrick released a track speaking about real Family Matters, about Drake's family. Meet the Grahams. Grahams is Drake's surname. So it's like Meet the Grahams. So Drake released Family Matters. Kendrick released Meet the Grahams. So people were like, oh, maybe Kendrick, he really has a mole. How did he know Drake was gonna release Family Matters? And then 30 minutes later, he releases a track called Meet the Grahams, speaking about the same topic Drake released, whereby it's Drake's family. Meet the Grahams. Meet the Grahams was released. There was 4 verses on Meet the Grahams. I think Meet the Graham was a proper strategy for Kendrick, you know, for releasing it after Family Matters was just released, you know. So the first verse was speaking about Kendrick was just trying to advise Drake's son, you know, Adenas. Kendrick was sending a message and was speaking directly to Drake's son, speaking about how his father is not a present father, how his father has failed as a father, speaking about how Drake doesn't teach his child any reasonable, important life lessons, speaking about how, was also sharing advice to Drake's son about how to maneuver as a man in the world. Don't allow people to bully you around. Don't take shortcuts. You have to go to the gym. Don't do what your father did. Allegedly, Drake did a surgery to get six pack. How do you even do a surgery to get six pack, bro? Like, just go to the gym. Or don't even need a gym. Like, just do sit ups there. Just go and jog. Do something. It's easy to get a six pack, man. But surgery, like, okay. Like, what's up, Drake? Why are you getting a surgery? So yeah. Then the second verse was dedicated to Drake's parents, Drake's mother, and Drake's father, exposing to Drake's parents how Drake is such a pedophile, how Drake is a drunkard, how Drake likes to gamble and likes to misuse money, and how Drake like hates black women. He treats black women as a fetish, and yeah, allegedly, according to Kendrick. And then the third verse was was dedicated to Drake's daughter, who Drake claims he doesn't have a daughter. But now it's been exposed that Drake has a daughter. So I'll speak about that on another video. So Drake has a daughter, according to Kendrick. Hey, Jakala, my thought. So that verse was dedicated to Drake's daughter, speaking to the daughter, telling the daughter that don't worry, since your father didn't claim you, don't take it as if you are not loved in the world. You still have people around you who love you. Just being a fatherly role, or being an adult in the situation, trying to speak to a young girl who is being abandoned by her father. So yeah, I think that was a proper strategy. And then of course the last verse was dedicated to Drake himself, speaking about how Kendrick didn't want this to be so personal. He just wanted it to be a nice exhibition in the game. But just because Drake is Kendrick's family, Kendrick didn't feel like there had to be limitations towards this beef. He can go all in, whether on his family, on his kids, on alleging that he's a pedophile, allegedly. So yeah, I think that was a great strategy, because Kendrick was explaining himself why he's doing this. You know, he was not being emotional about it. He was being an elder, he was being an adult, he was being a chess master, he was being the king and playing chess and moving the pieces in the game. So I think Kendrick's strategy has been a great strategy in this beef. And then before Drake could even reply, he released a banger song called Not Like This. A lot of people are liking it. It has a West Coast vibe. It was produced by DJ Mustard. Yes, Mustard on the beat. It's a track where now there's trends. There's even dance challenges about OVO. Like speaking about OVO being an OVO crew. You know, like OVOs. Like, what is OVO about? Is it bad niggas or bad bitches? So it's OVOs, you know. So Kendrick didn't mind going all in on Drake. His strategy was like to take it so personal, to destroy the man's character, destroy how people perceive him. Like Drake, Kendrick destroyed Drake's character. Now people are looking at Drake and questioning Drake's actions, questioning Drake's personality, Drake's character, how Drake has been moving. People are even starting to ask, did Drake sell his soul to the game? You know? So, and people are also questioning, is Drake really the man of the street? Is Drake really about it? Is Drake a street nigga, or is just a well-funded cheese boy? You know? So yeah, it was a great strategy. Then of course Drake released the final track. No, the final track, Family Matter. Ish. Oh, the last track Drake released was The Hard Part 6. which people are debating if it was a great response or what. So a lot of people are still asking, is the beef over? Is the beef over just like that? Is Kendrick still gonna reply? Is Drake still gonna reply? So we don't know what's gonna happen at this point. We don't know if Drake is gonna release another track dissing Kendrick or speaking about other things or defending his allegations. We don't know. We don't know if Kendrick is gonna reply and hit back, because Kendrick exposed how he has more tracks and he has more debt on Drake. So yeah, we're still sitting back, analyzing, watching what's gonna happen. So yeah, I think Kendrick's strategy was a fire strategy, and I think Kendrick killed this, and he went into this beef like a grown-up, like a well-calculated man, you know. So yeah, that's what I think. Share your thoughts there and let me know what you think.